Ladies, gentlemen, ethnic slurs all, I am unfortunately still alive, but regardless, I have finally returned to tell you that y'all motherfuckers need Onmyo. You see, out there are all these builds now. Unnecessary, but fascinating little things. I say unnecessary because all you need is Onmyo, and I'll show you why. You see, I don't like all this fuss, all the hours of farming, just to be a glass cannon that can one-shot a boss, but is uninteresting the rest of the time. But such disinterest raises a question deep within myself. If I don't like making meta builds, what do I like? Well, I like to be bad at video games, die, be unoriginal, and now I present to you a general and unoptimized Onmyo Magic Spirit build that has the potential to simultaneously tank hits from the biggest bosses and the hardest difficulty, and deal tens of thousands of damage from the front without having to risk being one-shot and feeling shitty about yourself. I'm using the set bonus for Grace of Tsukiyomi, which is one of the new set bonuses on Orange Gear that didn't have set bonuses before, which is why it is mismatched as balls. And this set bonus gives me better all-around Onmyo and allows me to fucking finally regenerate Onmyo magic. Why did it have to be so difficult, Team Ninja? First Dark Souls hates mages and now this? At two, Team Ninja? At two? I'm also using one piece of the Ica Ninja set for regenerating quick change scrolls. As far as stats go, I'm using 99 magic and 99 spirit, and since I was experimenting with some jutsu action, I was also using 99 dexterity, but it's not necessary for the build. I'm also using Date as my clan, as it lets you make good guardian spirits even better, and makes the weak ones more viable to tank with. And speaking of guardian spirits, pick any that you fucking want. I use Tengen Kujaku because elemental attack damage increases the damage of your Onmyo magic shots. All of them. And I'm also using Genbu as a secondary because having that extra Onmyo magic power also gives you a fairly substantial damage and duration boost across the board to Onmyo magic. And together, they let me life drain using Onmyo magic. This is pointless, but it sounds really cool. Now, while regenerating Onmyo is a very big part of making the build more freeform, if you don't have the DLC or in a pinch, you can always try using unlimited Onmyo on all your gear, as well as Shadowrun talismans to get more bang for your buck without regeneration. I will also say that it is generally more worthwhile for you to have faster casting rate mystic art for the Onmyo magic than the Onmyo magic duration art, especially if you are in possession of the Tsukiyomi set bonus. Applying buffs to yourself instantly will save lives. Get the instant ninja cast mystic art as well, so you can insta-cast quick change scrolls and more literally save your life. Speaking of specific things to cast, all Onmyo magics are viable with this setup. You simply need to think about what way to apply them. Do not think of an Onmyo mage as a simpleton casting a choice buff here and there and throwing out an elemental shot on occasion either. Think of, for example, the Onmyo mages that exist in the game already. They use spells that are better versions of your own spells, but they do not attempt to strategically use status ailments together. They often sit there and buff in your face repeatedly. They use their Onmyo magic talismans like goddamn Yu-Gi-Oh cards, and summon floating heads and cute foxes.
Why can't I do that?
In short, in order to be an effective Onmyo mage, you must play absolutely nothing like them. An Onmyo mage must be clever and use everything at his disposal. Allow me to demonstrate. Now, one of the effective ways to play this build is as follows. attune a guardian spirit that is fantastic at inflicting an elemental status ailment, and also attune one of the new elemental spells that is a different element from the guardian spirit. Also try to make sure that this spell is also one that you are good at hitting more than once per cast with. Gale Shot is perfect for this, since there really aren't any wind guardian spirits good at inflicting wind, and Gale Shot pretty much will inflict wind, unless the enemy is resistant. Also attune Extraction Talismans, Playtest Talismans, Leech or Carnage, Guardian Spirit Talismans, Weakness, and of course, the Quick Change Scrolls. Now apply all your buffs. Use Guardian Spirit Talisman, use Gale Shot. Congratulations, you have now blustered and staggered to hell any enemy in the game. Enemies now take a pretty big drop in defense while blustered, and if you're using a Guardian Spirit with good Amrita Gauge rate, you also now have full living weapon from nothing. Now use a Weakness Talisman if you're feeling particularly bloodthirsty today, or use it after you're in living weapon and completely and totally safe from being one-shot. Now if the enemy you are fighting is a yokai, boss or non-boss, it now has no key from being blustered, less defense from being blustered, less defense from Weakness Talisman, you now have a massive damage buff on yourself, and you have whatever attack damage increase percentage your Guardian Spirit offers, and the yokai can now be staggered locked by your attacks, and your attacks will generate Amrita to keep your Guardian Spirit up, and your Pleiades Talisman will increase how effective the Amrita you get is at increasing your living weapon gauge. Congratulations. Your enemy is now butter before your raging hot living weapon. And as soon as you put that living weapon away, all those casts that you just used, they're back again. And if you killed your enemy fast enough, your buffs are still up. So never hold back, boys. Granted, fighting human opponents will be a little more involved as they will block you. Putting a Pierce Guard on your weapon allows you to deal moderate damage through guard while also getting Amrita from dealing damage to them, which will often allow you to keep your living weapon up long enough to break their nigh-infinite guard and finish them off. Just keep an eye on your buffs in extended fights, and remember what I'm about to say. You can buff while swinging. If you're spamming attacks and a buff runs out, there is no need to let off the offense to rebuff. Just another thing to make instant buffs more useful. Priority 1 buffs to have on are Extraction Talisman and Quick Change Scroll. If suddenly your hand-rubbing maniacal laughter on your magical plans are foiled and you get fucked, your Quick Change Scroll will pop and you have another chance to get back at him. But remember that being born once again from the womb of thin air will purge you of all active positive status effects. So in that red alert situation, you need to put up a Quick Change Scroll first, and then an Extraction Talisman, and maybe a Regeneration Talisman if you're into actually having health. Then you can capitalize on the Extraction Talisman with a couple well-placed elemental shots, and bam boom, your living weapon is back up, and you are back in business, baby. And now to sort of wind this video down, let me just tell you something flat out. The build has almost nothing to do with the damage I was dealing. It was all through the synergetic use of Onmyo magic. I'm not even remotely built for any sort of melee at all. My weapons didn't have the nicest levels or pluses. I didn't even roll damage increases on them. The only percentage damage increases I was getting were out of my guardian spirits. The rest of it was all Onmyo, all magic, all of it. Imagine what kind of damage you could get out of this with even your existing builds. Onmyo is nearly just as effective when you aren't even built for it. So while making this build, I came to realize that a pure Onmyo mage is just as capable of ridiculous damage as any sort of complicated farm-to-hell, fleshed-out, optimized min-max build. You just have to use what you have at your disposal in smart ways, like a real mage. But now, all of this is just how I use Onmyo magic, with this particular setup. In the end, there's not even anything stopping you from making a super min-max build and also using Onmyo magic. Onmyo magic is whatever you need it to be. It can be a reliable source of damage. It can be that one buff or heal you need to get back into the fight. Or it can be that thing that no one credits as responsible for actually making their melee builds work. Onmyo magic and jutsus in general are tools. Some simple, some complicated. But all of them can be viable in the right context. And that's what I want you to take away from this. You don't really need to build yourself to hell to enjoy this game. You just need to do what you think is fun, what works best for you. Unless what is best to you somehow means don't ever put Quick Change Scrolls on. That is stupid. Always wear protection.
And now the video is over. I wrote an outro, but it sucked. We'll be right back.